Welcome. In this video I will walk you around some details of the Goxbox build. Let's start off with the initial sketch. This formerly classified blueprint was the starting point of all design activities around the system. As you can see, our plan was to give Mr. Gox some sort of manual trigger for placing orders. After we discovered that he loves crawling through tunnels, we came up with a sophisticated prototype to test out his acceptance for a tunnel-based trigger system. He happily adopted any additional tunnel in his habitat, and so we moved on searching for a way to trigger them without Mr. Gox noticing anything. The most promising option was to use weight sensors and trigger on a specific amount of weight detected in the tunnel. Some LED strips left us options for optically indicating successful triggers. This feature was deactivated later on because we were concerned it could upset him when resting in one of the tunnels. The whole construction was designed in a specific software, so we had 3D models of all components at hand to be able using digital prototyping methods. The sensor carrier was 3D printed and the outer covers were laser cut from hamster save wood. After solving the trading trigger issue, our next task was to figure out a reliable mechanism to track wheel movements precisely. Our plan was to stick with his existing wheel and add all the components needed without exposing Mr. Gox to any risk. An industrial-grade rotary encoder, which is a small device sending electrical pulses when being rotated, attached to some gear mechanism, gave us the chance to do so. As with the tunnels, all mechanical parts were 3D printed and covers were laser cut from wood. The sensor and electronics stuff are controlled by a microcontroller and connected via some quick and dirty breakout circuit board. Further versions of the system will be wired in a much cleaner way since we now know that everything works as intended. The main body of the box consists of interlocking plywood sheets that were glued together. In order to provide Mr. Gox with some adequate city view, we've added a backdrop window. Two big doors allow for easy cleaning and wooden latches secure them in place at low cost. Some big air vents make sure everything is well ventilated. The bridge between hamster home and office is called portal. The office side is detachable, and a floodgate prevents Mr. Gox from falling when one of his habitats is being cleaned. For the camera system, we wanted to achieve satisfying image quality while having the option to use infrared light for night vision as well as full manual lenses. After some testing, we went on with two high-res camera modules that allowed to unscrew the lens sockets and pop out the infrared filter glass. After fiddling with image settings for a long time, we had to accept a more or less poor image quality due to the infrared lighting in the system. This is kind of sad but inevitable for not disturbing the day and night cycles of Mr. Gox. Maybe we will come up with a better solution for this soon. By the way, the LED light source is pointing towards a wall of the office, resulting in indirect lighting, which prevents any hamster eyes from staring directly into it. After some days of test streaming, we felt the need for a proper hamster detection system that would indicate whether he is in the office or not. Two distance sensors did the job quite nicely. They are covered in wood and mounted height adjustable for optimized triggering. As soon as Mr. Gox enters or leaves the office, these sensors will pass a command to the main computer that shows or hides the out-of-office message accordingly. Besides everything described working surprisingly well, we also had to face some drawbacks. The plan to provide Mr. Gox with some functioning displays on his desk had to be discarded pretty early. The actual approach was to use three small e-ink displays, the ones you know from e-readers, to let him view his numbers and read messages from the Twitch chat. Due to the limited image quality of the cameras, any content on the displays was hardly readable. On top of that, we couldn't figure out a reliable and well-performing way to integrate them into the system in the given amount of time and with the hamster security measures necessary. We hope this insight was entertaining. Stay tuned for further updates.